Welcome back to Chasing Tails, where one of us freaking slapped the fox's ass. Fortunately, it's still seated. A web of cracked spirals across the TV screen. It resembles broken ice crust now. Rin turns completely white. Rin, you...
quiet. Not a word. I'll send you a new TV tomorrow.
Forget the TV. You all right?
Me?
First time since we met, we've met Rin. Looks generally confused.
I'm fine. What kind of weird question is that?
I just thought that.
Doesn't matter what you thought, I'm alright. I'm sorry about the TV.
Yeah, also am I gonna be fucking able to watch movies? I was planning to watch freaking Jurassic Park 1929! Oh no, I just numbers up there. Don't question me! There we go.
Like I said, I'll make sure you get a replacement tomorrow. It's too late to deal with the issues today anyways.
Rin's cheeks are getting blush black. Flash back on. And she sounds like her usual self. Still, there seems to be something seriously wrong with her. I wonder what that could be. Is it because she slapped the fox's ass? If that's the case, I consider what to say next so I don't upset her. Is she coming back? Why am I so fucking quiet? I don't know! This gets in her. Rin doesn't look at me. She bites her lip in silence, then rips a paper trap off the back of the TV.
I guess I should have used better quality paper.
Wait, the quality of the paper varies depending on what it is? The hell? Did I say something wrong?
I think she'll be back, yes.
Cool. Do I need to have a baseball bat?
She'll sit lay low for a while, and then she'll go back to her old ways. Unless she's stopped by it, of course.
Do I need to grab a newspaper?
At least now I know for sure that my assumption was correct.
Why am I so fucking quiet? I'll be back! There we go, I hope I fixed it. Hopefully. Because at least we can figure these things out. Hopefully. I'm not even tech support, I have to figure this. Back to the story. What assumption?
I had a hunch, but I didn't want to scare you until I knew for sure. I think we have enough evidence now. You're being haunted by a kitsune.
Do I have to get a newspaper and start smacking her?
Either she's stealing your energy or she wants to take your place.
I give her food. Why?
It's okay, don't get jumpy. I know what we should do. What do you mean, take my place? Well, once Kitsune finds a lonely girl, a young girl, she starts counting her cornering her until she gets her way. Legend has it that Kitsunes are able to enter their victims' bodies through their fingernails. Or through their breasts! Fucking asshole! Do you like it though? What are you doing?
Sorry, I can't help myself.
This is totally kids friendly. I hope YouTube doesn't kill me for this.
You had such a terrible face.
Hey, that would have deserved an elbow to the face.
Well, of course I had.
Who would take this lightly? I'll say if maybe me. Triple wielding newspapers to take down Kitsune. Sounds so dumb, but it sounds like something even I would do for fun. God damn. It's just creepy. And shrugs.
It's nothing special, just the usual Kitsune shrug. Shin gigs. They're dangerous, I told you.
Do I need to increase the audio on the video? Y'all, there we go. Now I've increased the sound. You guys can kind of hear it. Kind of. That doesn't mean you guys can.
Kitsune's can hurt you. Many different ways. They used to possess people very often back in the day. But I doubt our fox is such a girl.
Why not?
She would have done it by now if she wanted to.
I don't understand. Why is she attacking me? My ancestors had some sort of business with the kids there. Facts, yes?
Indeed. That's how it should have been with your dark mage ancestors. Not the magic powers, though you're just a tidbit with no protection.
I have newspapers! I can start smacking her with it! It will do nothing, of course!
Or rather, that's what the fox thought. I most hardly hope she won't be able to sit for quite some time.
Well, you did slap her ass! What do you want me to say? You freaking went all in on that booty. What am I gonna do?
Well, just slap her ass. Is that not an option? Don't worry, I have a plan.
Is it my plan? I like my plan. It's dumb. And very dumb.
Now we have plenty of time to prepare. Our fox got a magical thrashing. She'll have to lay low to gather her strength for new exploits.
So I'm safe.
Yes, for now.
face.
Besides, I'm still hoping for dinner.
Saying that the fucking fox ate it. Wait a minute.
You little...
Before I knew it, Rin storms out of the room. She just realized the damned fox ate the food. Rin, wait. I rush into the kitchen after Rin. She's frozen over the stove, looking even whiter than she did at the TV.
I can't believe this wicked magic.
What happened?
The meat. We've been beaten, robbed clear of all meat.
We spent the rest of the evening cleaning up the kitchen, trying to cook something with the ingredients that served. Asshole, you could have left me like one bowl. Like, come on, at least half a bowl. Fine, at least half a bowl. No, Rin no longer complains, and I can't tell. I can tell she's really trying to help me as much as she can. She's doing great at times, but all in. All in all, we somehow manage. When it's time to do dishes, the friend disappears. I decide to regain myself in the fact. I mean, she must have done more housework today than ever before in her entire life. Back where it belongs. I can't help but listen to my surroundings. It's already quite dark outside, and you still have the window open. I didn't even want to look at the clock, so I didn't get upset. So I don't get upset. But just as Rin promised, the house is completely silent. Over with and finally calmed down, I decided to go through all the rooms. Oh, there you are. He's asleep! Rin is sleeping peacefully on the couch. I quietly walk closer, trying not to disturb her. In her sleep, down and breathe and fall asleep. She's probably exhausted. Give me more options. Only options to save, goddammit. There we go. Now I know which one I want to go with. I'll be a little nice. Throw a blanket on her. That seems even more tempting. Just leave everything as it is. That'll be nice and comfortable like it. Although Rin is fully closed, the house is chilly. It can get even colder than the morning. I get a couple of blankets finally get a mirror in his face. Still in my head, touches something hard. It's the book. That book. And I think